All right, we have a guest today. Check this out. Sergeant John Muse. Hey, what's up, Sarge?
Well, how are you, buddy?
Can you do one thing for me first? Can you yell at me like I'm a bad cop?
Yeah, you gotta learn to just be a better guy. That's all. That's the best yelling I can do. I'm not a yeller.
He's not a yeller? I want that streets of San Francisco yelling at me. Okay. How you doing, John?
Not bad.
Shake your hand again. Now, if you remember, we were airing some Junior J's clips. I'm sure you've seen the one we did on bullying, and we brought Sergeant Muse in here just to talk about bullying. So, I guess my first question is, why does bullying happen? Like, I remember it happened to me, but we'll talk about that later. But
well, usually when it happens, it's often the person that is insecure. They're insecure with themselves, they're jealous, so they got to pick on somebody that they see as vulnerable. And it might be somebody that does well in school, might be somebody that they see as like a geek, or it might be somebody smaller.
Somebody who's physically small.
and what you'll also find is, more often than not, when the bully's doing that, he or she is doing it with a bunch of friends.
Right.
Because really, bullying is cowardly. And cowards bully. And so cowards have their friends around normally. Although the segment, you know, is somebody by himself. The bottom line is, these are just cowards. And you know what? Young people don't have to take it, and they can do a number of things to stop it. They don't have to accept it.
Like what?
Say. Well, there's a number of things. One thing you can do, everybody responds differently, okay?
That's
in the sort
very
of the
true.
Face of danger and things that are making you frightened. We all get frightened.
Oh, I get frightened. Your adrenaline's just going.
And it's like, oh my God, look at this guy. He's bigger than me. I'm frightened. But and so we all respond differently. One way could be by facing a bully down.
Right.
There's nothing wrong with that. That's a good way to respond, because more often than not, the bully's not used to that. And when somebody faces a bully down, the bully's taken aback and surprised, and often the bully will end up just walking away. Another way is to just say, hey, look, I don't have to be part of this, and turn the other cheek or walk away. And I know in today's society amongst young people, that is seen as like a not a cool, hip thing to do. It's seen as a cowardly thing. But wrong-o, I was talking the other day to one of the Raptors. Very cool guy. And there was a, talking to a few of them. And,
okay.
And I was talking to Tony Massenberg and Tracy Murray.
Yeah,
really,
Tracy.
Really nice guys. And one of them, I can't remember which one said, but one of them said, hey, you know what? It takes guts to turn the other cheek and walk away and not get involved in their activity. The vast majority of young people don't want to get involved. So face them down, walk the other way, laugh at them, say to them, I don't want to be part of this. There's a number of things you can do without getting into it with the bully.
Now, what's an example of the wrong thing to do?
Well, definitely the wrong thing to do, and the thing that happens all the time, is when somebody gets bullied and say maybe something happens to them or they take them on, but what that person will often do is go get their group of friends. And what started off as a bullying incident ends up with two groups going at it. And we all know that when two groups go at it, what you might end up with is a gang fight. And what happens, what gets brought to a gang fight? Weapons. So it is a bad road to travel, and if you travel down that road, somebody's going to get hurt, somebody's going to get beaten, somebody's going to get stabbed, and that could be you, that could be the other person you're facing, and nobody, I believe, wants that.
Wow. Okay, we'll be back with John.
All right.
Thank you.
Okay.
How about a game?